All right, everybody, I thought I'd update a little bit on what's going on with the storm. I don't know a lot, and the reason I don't know a lot, I want to explain why that is. The thing about forecasting winter storms is you're only as good at forecasting as your skill level, your experience, and the data we get. Well, the data we're getting right now is not all that good. The GFS model has been all over the place. The last four runs have been four completely different runs from each other, so I just threw that model out because you need consistency. Like a car, you don't want it sputtering, stopping, and starting. You want it to run smooth and clean, and the GFS just isn't doing that. The other thing that makes it tough about winter weather forecasting is there's about 8 to 10 variables I have to look at. I got to look at the position of the high, the strength of the high, those are two. I got to look at the strength of the low, the track of the low, that's two more, now we're up to four. I got to look at the amount of moisture, that's five. I got to look at the temperature at the surface at 5,000, at 10,000. So we're getting up around 8 or 9 different variables. And right now, a lot of those variables are unknown. A good way to explain this is if you've ever played or watched Wheel of Fortune. And Wheel of Fortune, the more numbers or letters, I should say, that get revealed, the easier it is to solve the puzzle. Well, it's the same thing with forecasting weather. The more that we know, the more numbers that get revealed, the better it is or the easier it is to forecast what the storm is going to be. In this case, we don't even know how many characters there are or what category we're in. Now, we're beginning to know that. We're beginning to know the category. We know it's going to be rain or snow likely. We're beginning to know the number of characters, and that would basically be the timing. The problem is we don't have a lot of letters revealed yet, so it's making it very difficult to solve or forecast this storm. So let me show you what I think is going to happen based on the one model that I know has done the best job this winter so far, and that is the European model. And here's what I'm going with right now. The GFS was garbage. We're going to throw that out. Once the low forms down here, which will happen late Monday, that eliminates two variables. Now, at least I have a low. I know how strong it is right over the Gulf, and I know the track. So I'm eliminating variables. I also have a good idea what's going on with the high pressure over the Northeast here and where it is. So that eliminates two more variables. And you can see, as these things reveal themselves, it becomes there's a lot less guessing in doing the forecast. So as I go out into the future, I notice the first thing here, Tuesday night, it looks like a rain-snow mix for the mountains and foothills. Oh, sorry about that. Here on Tuesday night into Wednesday. But it looks like probably rain, cold rain or snow. But, I mean, the difference here is about 25 miles between rain or snow. The interesting thing is the storm winds up and moves up the coast. We get into the overnight hours into Wednesday morning, so it's colder, obviously, at night. And we're also wrapping in cold air from the north, so the 540 line, or the rain-snow line, actually shifts east of Charlotte right through the central part of basically the Union Anson County line. And that this little area would be a heavy snow band. So the possibility is that we could see this start as rain, go to snow, and then go to nothing. So that's some of the things I'm looking at. And so because I know that, I got to stick with at least some snow in this storm. I can't go with 100% rain because just looking at the most consistent model and the best data so far, this all tells me this is likely going to be a rain-snow mix. That's about the best thing I know is that we don't know it's ice. We know it's not ice, I should say now, and we know it's just going to be rain or snow. And then the system moves out of here quickly. But the one thing I don't like about the European model, it tracks it pretty close to the coast, but I do like this track, to be honest with you. If you notice, it's right at the coast, so it's doing a little better, and that makes sense from a historical and from a meteorological standpoint. If you look at most of the snowstorms and nor'easters and Miller A-type systems, they tend to kind of track on the coast or slightly offshore. They rarely track inland. That's a very rare event, and that doesn't mean it's not going to happen, but that just kind of gives me kind of pause here. So we don't know a lot, but we're getting a better idea, and I think by tomorrow into Monday, we're really going to know a lot more. But I wanted to let you know that's what I'm looking at right now and why it's so difficult sometimes to forecast these systems. Hope you're having a great weekend. I'll be on at 11 o'clock, and of course, I'll keep you up to date throughout the weekend. We'll probably do another blog Sunday night into Monday morning. Be a little more complete than this quick and easy video here. Have a great night.